Hey, welcome to Jet City. Today's video is the next day. It's a follow-up to the previous video, which is called Starting an Early J79 versus the F119, where we sort of compare starting sequences of the J79 versus the engine in the F22. So the J79 has an external start cart supplying, well, let's go from the beginning. It has an electric starter motor that starts a small gas turbine engine that has a big bleed valve from that compressor that sends air at about 30 psi through a hose to the J79's air turbine starter, which spins up the main rotor to starting RPM. Away we go. And that is featured in yesterday's video. I filmed it today as well from a different angle. Yes. It'll be there. Okay, versus the F119 and the F22, which has a solid propellant cartridge that turns a small starter power turbine, little teeny thing, that gets a small gas turbine engine running. And from there, it's similar to the J79. The small gas turbine engine has a bleed valve on its compressor, which then supplies air through tubing to an air turbine starter on each of the two engines, with a diverter valve from one to the other. And those tiny air turbine starters spin up the HP core, or the fuel burning core, or the basic engine inside the LP system in each of the F119s. Okay, so today we started it, ran it till it warmed up, and got some afterburner footage. It was a very interesting day. But first I'll say, warming up the engine is basically warming up the oil. We wait until the oil reservoir hits 100 degrees Fahrenheit. But the warm up for a jet engine is not necessary. If you really need to get going, you start it. As soon as it's burning fuel and gets up to idle, you can take it right to full power, no sweat. As talked about in my video called Cool Your Jets, you have to cool it down slowly. But to heat it up, no big deal. Ready right away. So let's have a look at that now. It's pretty cool. Okay, that sound you're hearing is the turbine blades hitting the tip shrouds, and that's normal. It's a little snug. The snugger the better the power. All part of the a good build of the engine. And that was fun. I moved the camera twice because twice the camera got blown over because with these short petal nozzles, the screamers, that we don't have as much experience with, the cone of the exhaust stream is wider. That was an interesting experience. We were getting hit by rocks. And the camera got literally blown over twice. Thanks for watching. Okay, two things make today's J79 test a little bit more interesting than the usual ones we test. Normally we test the J1E, which is a modified -17, which has the low smoke combustors, or the newer combustors, and fuel nozzles. And it also has the updated exhaust nozzle. And that's the variable exhaust nozzle for the afterburner and the thrust augmentation and the varying diameter for varying levels of thrust and RPM. Okay, so the -11B has the short nozzle and the original combustors. So it makes a lot of black smoke. And it also has what we call the screamer or the howler nozzle. Those short petals, they make a howling noise at part power. Now, I always thought that that was just an undesirable side effect and it was engineered out with no other real change. But we found out today that there's another change. So I was standing along the lines of the, what would you call it? It's a long, narrow cone of exhaust gases that come out of the tail end of the jet. The ideal turbojet has exhaust gas that's exactly parallel going straight out the back with no residual pressure, and so it doesn't expand into a cone. Nothing's ideal. But the J1E, the more modern J79, has a particular angle, we never really measured it, of exit of the exhaust cone. Okay? So I was standing outside of that based on my experience from many other engine tests. And you'll see, or you did see, you will see, again, if you watch it again, the camera gets blown over. And I got blown over the first time. I got blown off my feet when we went to military power. And then I moved the camera 10 feet over, and it was still dangerous. As a matter of fact, I was getting hit by small rocks, and I saw a rock the size of, I guess, a walnut or something like that, go zinging past my head. Now, I'm way off the axis of the thrust of the engine, but I'm obviously still not far enough. So I moved it again, and that's where I took the rest of the footage. I also noticed that because that cone is wider and the engine is a bit lower in our new test cell setup, that it was really picking up some stuff on the ground. There was a couple of good-sized rocks rolling down the field, so hopefully we caught those on videotape pretty good, or video memory. Anyway, so we see an illustration here that designing a jet engine is always a process of optimization with trade-offs, because the low-smoke, more modern combustors for the J79, they're not more efficient, they're actually less efficient. The engine burns more fuel per minute at full power with those combustors than the original ones. So you would say, I would say that the engine is less efficient, but hold on. The exhaust nozzle was also changed. So if the exhaust has pressure in it, residual pressure, that's wasted power, because once it leaves the engine, then it starts to expand and it doesn't do anything except move the atmosphere around. So if your exhaust nozzle can fully accelerate the exhaust so that it's got maximum speed and minimum pressure, the angle of expansion of that exhaust cone is less. And that's what the new ones do. So the low smoke and modern nozzle combination for the J79, I know it's an old engine, but the more modern nozzle and combustor combination, the engine burns more fuel per minute, per unit time, but the engine makes more thrust. for a different reason. It's not burning more fuel and making more power. It's burning more fuel and it's using those exhaust gases more efficiently. It's expanding them in the exhaust nozzle rearward versus having them expand outward once they leave the engine. So very interesting, and I discovered that the hard way. I'm just glad I didn't get hit in the face with a rock or anywhere else. But the actual camera, and it's a pretty big, it's a Manfrotto tripod. It's quite heavy. It's a big one. It was expensive. It was blown over with the video camera on it. Blown over, and I caught it the first time. I think I caught it the second time. Can't remember, it was all so exciting. So I hope you enjoyed that footage, and here's a couple more shots of the Afterburner. Thanks for watching.